As we have understood high-level instructions with respect to development lifecycle to interact with databases using JavaScript with Node.js and Mongoose, let us see how we can set up a project and also explore required APIs to establish a connection to MongoDB database. And also we'll be defining the model and validate it by just running some simple find command against the collection in MongoDB database. So first of all, we need to create a new directory. In our case, the directory name is mongoose demo. And then we have to run npm init so that we can actually create a simple node application. So here I am saying mkdir mongoose demo. I am getting into that directory here. Once we are in that directory, now we can say npm init, which will take care of creating a simple node application. First of all, it will prompt for the package name. By default, it will inherit the directory in which we have ran this npm command. You can see it here. We are in mongoose demo directory and it have inherited that as package name. I want to use itself as package name and hence I'm hitting enter directly. I don't want to change the version. I don't want to provide description. I want to leave the entry point as index.js. No test command, no git repository details, no keywords, no other license. Once we provide all the answers for these interactive questions, now it is saying that it is about to write this package.json in our project directory. So this is our project directory and this package.json will have this information. It have the name, version, description, main scripts, etc. Whatever is provided here. As of now, we are only interested in this mongoose demo, which is nothing but name of our application. And finally, as we have reviewed these details, as we are okay with it, we can just say yes, which is default. And now if you run ls-ltr, we can see this package.json file created. Now when it comes to developing node-based applications, we have to install the package. So if you want to interact with MongoDB database using Mongoose package, we have to install that Mongoose package. We can take care of that by saying npm install Mongoose. However, if I say npm install Mongoose, it will just download the JavaScript files with respect to this package. And if we try to build at a later point in time, it will fail because it doesn't know what all APIs we are trying to use as part of our code. One of the way to streamline this process is to include these dependencies in package.json so that the build tools can understand what all dependencies should be included when this application is built, and hence we have to say hyphen capital S so that package.json is updated with the dependency we are installing here. Now it will take care of installing Mongoose. You can see this node modules directory is created when we ran npm install command. And also if you review package.json, you can see Mongoose is added as one of the dependency. As Mongoose dependency is available for this project, now we can actually launch node. For now, I will be demonstrating using command line. Very soon we'll be using IDE and then we'll actually start developing the code using IDE. Using command line is not productive to build complex logic. But to just demonstrate how we can establish the connection, I will first start with the command line approach. Once we launch node, the first and foremost task we need to perform to use any plugin is to import that plugin. One of the ways to import the plugin with JavaScript is by creating a variable. You can give whatever name you want. I'm giving it as Mongoose here. And then we can invoke this function called require. And then we can add the plugin which is installed earlier. So by saying require Mongoose, we are actually importing all the Mongoose related APIs into this variable. Now you can say Mongoose here dot and hit tab. There are several APIs. One of the API which we can use to connect to the database is nothing but mongoose.connect. This is the one. Mongoose.connect takes several arguments. One of the argument is the URL to which we need to establish the connection. And then second argument is typically a JSON object which can take multiple options with respect to establishing the connection to the database. And this will return a promise. When it returns a promise, we need to handle the success and reject by invoking APIs such as then, catch, etc. So let's create a variable called as MongoDB. It is of type string, which contains the URL to connect to the MongoDB database. So in this case, I am saying MongoDB colon localhost, because localhost is the machine on which MongoDB server is running, and the port number for that is 27017. And then we can pass database name. We already have a database called as retail, and hence I am using that here. I am opening another tab here and ensuring that Mongo is currently running on my machine by running Mongo. And also I am ensuring that there is a database called as retail which contain collections such as orders, order items, etc. As we have orders, we'll be trying to read data from here just to ensure the complete lifecycle of using the Mongoose plugin, establish the connection with the database, and then just fetch the data and print on the screen. That being said, now I can say mongoose.connect. As I have mentioned to you earlier, it takes several arguments. One of the arguments is nothing but the URL in the form of a string. So in this case, it is nothing but MongoDB. And the second argument is nothing but a JSON object with several options. One of the options which we need to pass is nothing but use new URL parser, and we have to set it to true, and then we can close this. So this connect actually returns a promise, and I want to catch the reject scenario using catch. So catch takes a function as argument. Either we can pass regular function, or we can actually use arrow functions, which are new in JavaScript from ES6. So in this case, I will be using arrow function. This arrow function that is being passed to catch takes one argument, and that argument is nothing but the error message. To pass that error message, I am using the name as err, and then as we are using arrow function, we have to provide this imply equal to and greater than sign, and we can open the curly brace like this. And as part of this, I just want to throw error if there are any exceptions while connecting to the database, and then I want to close the curly brace for the arrow function, and then circular bracket for catch, and hit enter. Now it have established the connection with the database. As the connection is established, now we can use Mongoose, and then we can actually create a schema and a model. Once the model is created, using that model, we should be able to fetch the data from the collection in the database. So to create a model, first we need to create a schema. The way you can create the schema is by saying const with the variable name. So in this case, I'm going to create schema for orders. Typically, the schema name is singular unless and until the schema contains collection. That's why I have given the schema name as order schema. Mongoose have a class called schema. So you can invoke this constructor of the schema, and then you can pass the JSON object using which the schema will be constructed. So the way you can actually pass it is like this. Now we can specify the field names along with the data types. For that, we can go to database and run this db.orders.find1 and hit enter. So we have these four fields, and I want to specify that as part of the schema. So I can say order ID, which is of type number, order date, which is of type string, order customer ID, which is of type number, and then order status, which is of type string. This is how you can create the schema. This is the simplest form of the schema. We can actually add features such as ensuring values within a field whenever the document is inserted by using something called as required, and many other things. We will actually get into the details of enforcing the schema with several other attributes at a later point in time. As of now, we just created the schema with the field names and data types without any other characteristics with respect to each of these fields. That being said, once the schema is created, we have to create the model. And the way you can create the model is by saying const give the model name. In this case, I'm giving it as an order model. And then you can say mongoose.model. And this mongoose.model take three arguments. We have to at least pass two. The first one is nothing but the name of the model. Typically, it is singular unless and until the model have a list of documents in it. And then second argument is nothing but the schema name. Typically, if you specify model with the singular name, internally it will add yes, and it will assume that the collection name is plural. So it will directly point to the orders even if we do not specify the collection name as third argument. Whether you specify orders here or not, it will directly start using the orders collection. However, if you want to have a completely different name than the model, then you have to specify this third argument. So in this case, whether we say orders as third argument or not, it doesn't matter. It will work without any issues. Now the model is also created. Once the model is created, we can use this model, and there are several APIs on this model, like find one, find by ID, so on and so forth. In this case, I'll be using the find API without any condition. So we can just pass empty JSON like this. Again, this will actually return a promise. You can see here, actually it returns query, not promise. Once we build the query using find or find one or whatever API we want to, you have to invoke something called as exec. So we are trying to execute the query, and you can see that this exec function returns promise. Again, we need to handle then and catch for success and reject. So I can say orders or order model dot find exec, and then we can have then. So if it is successful, whatever results that comes as part of the query will be passed to this function which we are going to pass as part of the then. So either you can say function, and then let's say the collection is returned, and let's assume that it is nothing but orders here. So I can say function of orders like this, or we can also use the arrow function. So if you just want to use the arrow function, you just have to pass the name of the argument, and the type of this argument is nothing but the collection, because find returns collection. So whatever collection is returned, or whatever list of objects, documents are returned, or JSON objects are returned, is treated as orders here. So if you are using regular function, you just have to say curly brace like this, and you can have whatever logic you want. I am going to use arrow function, so we don't need to specify function keyword here. We can directly pass the argument like this. And orders is of type the list of JSON objects which are retrieved from the collection orders. And we can say imply. As this orders is of type collection, we can use APIs such as for each to iterate through the collection and perform whatever you want. If you want to process the data, you can use other APIs such as map, reduce, so on and so forth. All the APIs that are available as part of typical JavaScript array can be used on top of this collection. For now, to keep it simple, I'll be using for each. Here, I am going to take each and every JSON object that comes as part of this orders, and I just want to print on the console. So again, for each actually takes a function as argument. I'm using arrow function for that. And the argument name is order, because we are trying to process one order at a time. That's why I have specified order like this. As it is the arrow function, I have to use equal to and greater than, and then open the curly bracket. And then I just want to say console.log order like this. Close this curly brace for arrow function that is part of this for each. And then close the circle bracket for each. And then close the arrow function's curly brace for then. And then close circular bracket for then. Once we come up with the logic for success using then, we have to now come up with the logic for reject. And for that, we have to say catch. As part of the catch, we have to pass a function, and that function take one argument, which is typically an error, and hence I'm giving the name as error. We can just throw the error and then close this arrow function, and then catch and hit enter. Now you see data is being printed here on the screen. We have 68,883 records, and all of them are printed here. This is how you can actually develop the code to interact with the database. First of all, we need to import the package like this. Then you have to establish the connection to the database like this. Then you have to define the schema and model like this. And then you can invoke APIs such as find one or find to get the data. Find returns the collection, whereas find one returns one document, and hence I'm directly printing that document and then closing the connection as part of this code, which will be shared with you as part of the documentation. But as part of the demo, I have used find, which actually returned a collection when it is successful. If it is find one, it will just return one document. It will not return the entire collection. So depending upon the API, the data type of this argument that is passed to this arrow function changes. Okay. So this is how you can actually have a application developed using Mongoose as plugin as part of your node-based JavaScript applications.